Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, let us discuss about centripetal acceleration and we'll derive the expression for centripetal acceleration using two methods. One is the geometrical method, another is the calculus method. Hello students, let us start with the definition of centripetal acceleration, then we'll find the expression for centripetal acceleration. How this centripetal acceleration is derived, we'll derive the expression by two methods. One is the geometrical method and another one is the calculus method. So let us start with the geometrical method and the definition of centripetal acceleration. Now this is 1.5 centripetal acceleration. Acceleration is rate of change of velocity with time, and centripetal means that it is center seeking. It is looking for the center. Means it is which the acceleration which is always directed towards the center as long as the body is moving in the circular path. So if I want to write the definitions, then I write that it is that acceleration which is always acting towards the center of circular motion and is responsible for the circular motion of the body. So apart from the definition that I told you, I am not going to write that. What I am going to write is the derive the expression for centripetal acceleration. Centripetal is center of circular motion, obviously, and I will consider a circle, and suppose that the body is moving in a circle. This is the derivation part of centripetal acceleration. I'll write A over C, A sub C. This is the center, and suppose that at any instant the object is here at position A. Now it moves in anti-clockwise sense and comes to this point, say B, this point. Covering this distance, it goes to B. Now, if I want to find the acceleration, then I have to find the change in velocity. Suppose that the body takes time delta t to reach from A to B. So, and the angle it covers is, suppose it is delta theta. The velocity here is, because I'm talking about uniform circular motion, I'm just talking about the uniform circular motion, the speed I'll take constant. So here the velocity is supposing VA, and here the velocity is tangent, it is VB, at B position VB, at A position VA. If it is uniform, then VA and VB are same. This one is the OA vector, this one is OB vector. These are the radius vectors. But because the length will remain same, the magnitude will remain same because it is the circular motion. So if I want to find the expression for centripetal acceleration, I will consider that the body is moving with a constant speed. Now, in this situation, I will have to, in geometrical method, this method is geometrical method. In this geometrical method, we will compare the geometry of two triangles. These two vectors, radius vectors, are, you can see, at position A and position B, their magnitudes are same. If I join these two points by a straight line, this is the displacement vector from A to B, but I am not interested in the vector, I am interested in this length. Now, corresponding to this radius, this is the velocity, and corresponding to this radius, this is the velocity. The angle between the two radii will be the same as the angle between their corresponding tangents. That means if I see this to this position, this vector to this position, that is VA, then the angle between the corresponding velocities and the angle between the corresponding radius will remain same. That means if this angle is delta theta, this angle will also be delta theta. So this diagram, so what is the change in velocity? Initially it was like this, and finally it is like that. So this is the change. This is the initial, this is the change, and this is the final. So this is the change in velocity. Okay, so let me draw this triangle and this triangle again, because there we are going to use that. So the first triangle is like so. This is the triangle, and here it is something like this. These are the two situations. One is OAB, suppose this point is C and this point is D. So I write that this is O, this is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. This O is a vector, radius vector, that is radius vector RA vector. This is my RB vector, this is my VA vector, and this is my VV vector, and this is the change in velocity vector. Now, this angle is delta theta, and this angle is also delta theta that we have studied so far. And the circle you can complete if you want, then the circle is completing like that, and this is completing like that. Okay. Now, comparing these two triangles OAB, compare triangle OAB and also BCD, triangle BCD. Comparing these two triangles, OAB, also BCD. In this triangle, you can also have a side angle side test, SAS test, or we'll do that by side angle side test. In this triangle, this side is CD, and these two sides are same, VA and VV is say V, because uniform circular motion, the magnitude of velocity vector is same. Similarly, the RA and RB is say R because it is a circular motion. Okay. So this side, that means a right comparing CD, the CD. So CD over
centripetal acceleration.
So cut it karna hai na usko. Continuation of centripetal acceleration. CD over BC, this side over this side, because this is angle, same angle. So corresponding to that, for this triangle, this side over this side will also remain same. That is AB over OB, these two will remain same. This is very clear. In other words, you can also think of a triangle and or a circular path like that, and angle is arc length upon radius, because angle is same, the arc length is this one and radius is this one, that will remain same for these two triangles. Now CD is your delta V, change in velocity vector, because this is the initial velocity vector. I add this change, I get the final. BC is obviously V, VA, VB, that the BC is the velocity vector represented, this magnitude part of the velocity vector. This equals to AB, which is nothing but I will consider this AB as the arc length delta S, the displacement vector. So this is the displacement vector, I'll call it delta S, over OB is obviously the radius, this one or this one, it means the same thing, radius OB, that is RB, which is R. So this is what we've got, that is the very important expression. From here we can get the answer. Now, as I have told you, that the body takes time delta T to move from A to B, so that means the change in this velocity is occurring in this much of time. So that means all this change is occurring in time delta T. So from here I can write one more expression, that delta V equals to the V is taken out and delta S. Okay, this is the change in velocity vector if you want to write in terms of velocity vector. If I want acceleration, the acceleration is the dv over dt, that is the instantaneous acceleration, that is the rate of change of velocity. Here the change in velocity is delta v. If I divide that change in the corresponding time for the change, then I will get the average acceleration. This is the average acceleration over the interval delta t. And this delta V by delta T can be written as I can do one thing, I can divide delta T over here and delta T over here. So this expression will be V by R delta S by delta T. So V by R delta S over delta T. This is the expression. What we have done in the previous expression, we have divided delta T on both sides. This is delta V, which is the average acceleration I'm getting during the period A to B, but I want instantaneous acceleration. The instantaneous acceleration is given by the limiting value of average acceleration. This is the instantaneous, or we simply write A equals to limit delta t tends to 0. This is nothing but this one, because this and this are same, so write V over R delta S over delta T. V and R are constant, as we have already taken here, V and R are constant because it is uniform circular motion. So that is taken out of the limit, and we are left with V by R limit delta t tends to 0 delta S over delta t. So from here, V by R limit delta t tends to 0 delta S over delta t, but by definition, this is the average velocity and this limiting is the instantaneous velocity. So this means A equals to V by R into V, because V equals to limit delta t tends to 0 delta S over delta t. This is what we got last time. So this is nothing but you can write a ds over dt, which is the velocity. So from here in scalar form it is v square over r. This we have derived in scalar form, that the centripetal acceleration is in terms of its magnitude is v square by r. So the magnitude of centripetal acceleration is given by v square over r. This can also be written in different form. Like, because we know that V equals to omega R that we have discussed earlier, if I put V as omega R here, I will have omega square R. If I put R as V by omega, then I will have V omega. So these are the three formulae we've got. That is V square by R, V omega square R, and V omega. When both the velocities are together, when only angular velocity is there, when only linear velocity is there. So what about the direction that we have to find? Because it is acceleration, the magnitude part is this one, that is fine. What about the acceleration? As you can see from the diagram, this is the change in velocity vector. So this is the change in velocity vector. If I want to find instantaneous acceleration, then this change must occur in a very small interval of time. That means this delta t must tend to 0. If this delta t tends to 0, then this point B will be very close to this. If this point is very close to, the B is very close to A, V is approaching A, then the diagram can be thought of as like that. In this situation, the very close, just a line, small line, and this is perpendicular to this, and this should be perpendicular to this one, because it's very, very small. Similarly, if you think of this, if this d theta, delta theta is reducing to d theta, then that is also reducing. In the above case, we will have a situation like this. This initial is very close to final velocity. This is the change in velocity. That is the direction of acceleration. This is the direction of acceleration. This one. And that is perpendicular to both the velocities. The velocity at any instant, the velocity is perpendicular to the velocity. If the velocity is this way, then acceleration has to be perpendicular, means it should be like that. If the velocity is tangent, then this acceleration should be along the radius. And as we have seen, it is centripetal in nature, it is always towards the center. That means the acceleration, this delta V, is actually in this direction. This is the direction of acceleration, and that also is the direction of the change in velocity. Obviously, it's very, very small, delta V dV. So finally, we got the formula and the direction. Next, we'll discuss about the acceleration using another method that is known as calculus method.